Well, I think because if we don't care about landscape, I mean, who is going to care about it? And because if we don't care about landscape, because everybody is living in the landscape, we are going to have a serious problem in terms of in the 20, 30 years from now, where are we going to live when the landscape will be depleted? Well, we started this research on C4 landscape. I mean, sort of, you really want to go back, and so we started with something we called the multidisciplinary landscape assessment, and it was fundamentally trying to answer a very simple question: what matters in the landscape for local people? And then when you start to ask this question, then you are surprised by the answer, and the complexity and how much people are using in the landscape, how much they are depending on things that are in fact exist and are not substitutable. And that's what C4 is bringing, is trying to develop a framework for people to understand what it means, managing at the landscape level, and also trying to operationalize that. Well, the research C4 made about indigenous group or local communities, or in fact started with the whole idea of basic idea that if people don't have control of their own land, they have no interest whatsoever to preserve it on the long term. So it becomes what everybody has been calling the tragedy of the commons. So if I don't harvest this resource, someone else, and eventually not from the community, will harvest it, and it will be lost. So I'd rather take it for myself and eventually use the income to invest in something else. Indigenous people, and then we were going to sign an MOU with the group this afternoon, and that's basically because I think that we need to bring them at the table. As Roberto said yesterday, I mean, so I like the quote, I mean, if you don't sit at the table, you end up in the menu. So I quite like this quote, and I think it's true for everybody. So that was the beginning, and that it has involved also in other issues like, okay, is it the case that something that is managed by local people is always better managed than it's managed by the states? And the answer is complex. It's not the same thing in Latin America, in Africa, I think, but overall what seems to appear as a sort of the general pattern is that a mixed system with a state creating an enabling environment and a local community having rights on some of the resources and being able to exercise the right is the best combination. The way the youth community has been involved in the Global Landscape Forum, I think that's it's evolving from volunteers that will come and work with us because they are interested by the topic, they can, to a real involvement, the real seat on the table together with the indigenous group and the scientist and the policymaker and a voice. So that's where we are moving. We have made a lot of progress, and I hope that we are going to go further. I mean, so I think that's, in a sense, in the same way that you want to give the indigenous people the rights on their land, you want to give to the youth control on their future. First, really, if you see if we can create a movement around this idea of the sustainable landscape management, if we want to have some action on the ground that we can say have been the result of the landscape forum, if we want to see a new partnership that will be the result of people participating in these conferences, if you want to see, if we can see more youth interested in pursuing this type of work when they grow up instead of trying to be a banker in the city or anything, I think that that will be that. I mean, ultimately we will be judged on if something happened on the ground. We need to address the problem of restoration now, but also we need to address why is it degraded in the first instance? Because if we don't stop the degradation, then we will be running till the end of the time after the degradation and the restoration. And I guess that's will be a huge success for the Global Landscape Forum if, thanks to this collaboration, thanks to this discussion, people really manage to tackle at the same time, okay, let's stop degradation and let's restore what is degraded. That's one example. How is it going to be done? Is it going to be thousands of initiatives here and there? Or one global, I have no idea. I mean, so then that's not for me to decide, it's for the people that participate to the Landscape Forum. Why do we need science to inform the debate? I mean, because that's the purpose of science. I mean, it's sort of, okay, the purpose of science is discovery, but then it's not enough. I mean, it's sort of, okay, what do you do with this discovery so that, in fact, the whole idea is that progress. And you can translate progress in terms of technological progress or progress in terms of people are better, they have a better livelihood, they have a better life, they live in a more friendly environment, and in the end we are living on one planet and we keep this planet healthy. Why science matters? Because that's because knowledge matters, and without knowledge there is ignorance, with ignorance there is intolerance, with intolerance we have all the fanatism you want in the world. Yeah.